Hey everybody, in this tutorial we're going to learn the very basics of Character Creator 3. So if you're a beginner, this is the tutorial for you. We'll walk you through the basic steps of camera navigation and how to modify your character. And then we have other tutorials that you can explore other types of tools. All right, so let's go ahead and get started first with camera navigation. Okay, so up on the top we have a toolbar here with a number of different icons right here. You should see these ones right here. If you don't see that, you can go to Window, and you can go to Toolbar, and then you can go to Camera. Okay, so you can deselect that Window, Toolbar, and Camera. And you'll see those camera options there as well. We'll talk more about this kind of stuff in the UI tutorial. You can see there's a number of different options. There's Zoom, which is the Z hotkey, Pan, which is the X hotkey, and Orbit, which is the C hotkey. Okay, we'll talk about these hotkeys a little bit later. But if I want to zoom, I can just use this or press the Z hotkey and zoom in my view just like this. I can use this hotkey right here, or just press this, which is Pan, or use the X hotkey. Okay. I can click this button here, or use the C hotkey to orbit. Okay. Pretty straightforward. But generally, I don't normally use those options, and I think a lot of people don't as well, because we have this tool over here called the Select tool. You can also use the Q hotkey. Okay. And the Select tool is very useful because you can just left click on anything, like double click it, and I can select my character's top here. I can double click down here and select the bottom. I can click my character's body and select the body, okay, by left clicking. Now, the advantage of using this is you can select things and you can also hold the Alt key, okay? So hold the Alt key and left click your mouse button and you'll be able to pan just like this, okay? So you don't have to use the pan camera tool. You can just do this. If you hold the Alt key and you right click your mouse button, you're going to orbit your character just like this, okay? And holding your Alt key and both mouse buttons, you're going to zoom in on your character. You can zoom in and zoom out, depending on where you drag your mouse. Okay? Now, you don't have to hold the Alt key to zoom in and out. You can just scroll your mouse wheel. If you have a mouse wheel, scroll your mouse wheel, and you'll zoom in and out just like this as well. Okay? So then you can just, you know, select things. And then if you want to move your camera, just hold the Alt key and click and drag to a view that you like. Pretty simple stuff. Okay? Let's take a look now at different camera hotkeys to focus on different areas of your character. And those can be found in under this little menu here. So right now it's at face, okay? Let's click on the side here, and you can see we have basically all of the keys on our home row. ASDF, GHJKL on your home row on your keyboard. And if you want, you can click these, and it'll basically snap your camera to a certain view. Like F will be the front. S will be our character's side, okay? And G will be the top, okay? So basically, you can just, you know, click on this menu, drop-down menu, and select from here. Or I can just use A, which will give a view from our character's right side here. S from the left side. D from behind. F is focused on the character's front. And G will be above. H doesn't do anything, but the J hotkey is very important. I use this very often. You press the J hotkey, it'll focus on your character's face, okay? You can see the little face icon shows up here with a J in parentheses, okay? And then K will give you basically an overall view of everything that you have selected in your scene, or everything that's in your scene, rather. Okay, so that's a brief overview of camera movement, very simple stuff. Let's take a look now at modifying our character. Very simple modifications, very simple and straightforward. So we have a few sections up here in our content manager. So this is where all of our content is. We have the project section right here. We have the base section, which contains our morphs and basically physical body traits. And right here is our skin, cloth, accessory, pose, and stage elements. We'll talk about those a bit more in the UI tutorial. But for now, we're just going to focus on slightly modifying our character. Okay, so we're going to use the our base section right here. And there's a bunch of different subsections. Here you can see there's skin and morphs. There's a full body morph. There's only body, and there's head, and there's hair, teeth, and eyes, okay? We're going to use the full body morph section, okay? Just click on it right here, and basically you'll come up with a number of different items like this, okay? And we can see we have one called CC1 base female. Now, if I click on this, if I double click on it, basically what it's going to do is it's going to modify my character's body morphs and facial morphs because it's full body, okay? So if I double click on this CC1 base female right now, it's basically going to apply that morph to my character's body. Okay, and you'll see that she'll change. All right, just like this. All right, that's how you can modify your morphs. Now, you'll also notice that when I mouse over my character here, there's different sections that are being highlighted in yellow. And this means that you can actually click and drag on your character to morph different parts. So if I have my mouse over here and I left click and drag, and I left click and drag down, I can thin out my character's upper arms just like that, or make them larger, just like this, okay? I can also do that with other sections, such as our character's midsection, okay? I click and drag just like this and make the midsection smaller, depending on where you click and drag, okay? And the thighs as well. We'll just do like one more example. Okay, you can thin out those thighs. So a very easy way to just modify your character's body morphs and facial morphs as well. Now, if you don't have this yellow highlight over your character when you mouse over, you'll want to go up here and make sure that the morph gizmo is toggled on. And if you don't see this entire section here, again, you go to Window, go to Toolbar, and go to Modify Tools. All right, Modify Tools, that will be the one that you want to bring up to toggle your morph gizmo on and off. All right, so let's use the hotkey that we just learned earlier, the J hotkey, just to focus on our character's face. And we can do the same thing with our character's face as well. We can click on the ears. We can bring those ears out like this if we want. We can make the nose a little bit wider, just like this, okay? Now as well, over here we have the Modify tab, okay? The Modify panel. Now the Modify panel, we have a section here called Morphs, all right? Just click on the Morphs and you'll see a whole list of morphs on your character. Now I may have some here that you don't have because I've purchased additional content from the content store. But you should have most of the basics. Now you can do things under the head section here, like the head. We can go to brow, for example, and let's just go down here. We can go to brows, let's see, a very simple brow on brow height, for example. We can click and drag that slider. We can adjust the brow height to a higher level or a lower level, just like this. We can also adjust the brow angle, okay? Very simple, straightforward. And you'll notice as well on the right-hand side here, let's just click and drag this over a little bit. On the right-hand side here, we have a value we can also enter in. We can enter in like a plus 50, okay? Just like that. And if we enter like a minus 50, it'll be the opposite direction, just like this. And if we double-click on the parameter name, it will reset it back to the default. Okay, so double-click on brow angle, it'll reset it back to default. All right, so you can also use all of these sliders here. And if you want, I can search something like, I can go to head, just click on the head, and I can go into search tab here and search in something like mouth, for example. And every slider, every morph slider with the mouth word in it will appear, all right? You can see there's a lot right here. Very detailed mouth morphs if you want to use them. All right, so next let's look at applying some stuff to our character, some clothing and some hair and some everything, basically. All right, so what we're going to do here is we're first going to go over to, in our base section here, we have body morph, like I mentioned, head morph. Let's go over here to hair, okay? Now in hair, we have a number of default embedded hairs, okay? Most likely these ones right here. All right, then these are a few other packs that I've purchased. You can purchase from the content store. Let's go ahead and just apply this Dawn morph hair, okay? If we double click it, we can just apply it to our character. We don't need to click and drag it onto our character. It'll just apply like this. We can rotate and see we have a very nice looking, short hairstyle for this female character. Now what we're going to do next is go over to eyes. All right, so we can also apply for teeth. Okay, we already have teeth on our character. We can just go over here to eyes. And let's just apply a default eye, okay? One of these default eyes, like a 08. Give her some nice brown slash hazel. And what we're going to do is replace the entire eye, okay? We'll talk about that a little bit later on. So just click replace, and you can see now we have our character with beautiful brown eyes. All right, so that's a lot of the stuff, you know, for your character's physical traits. What we can do next is go over here to clothing, okay? The cloth section. Now in the cloth section, there's all kinds of stuff that you can select. Let's press the K hotkey to focus on our entire character. Let's take a look at what we can apply to our character. Maybe we'll zoom in a little bit here, just like this. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to just go into the main section here under underwear. We're just going to go ahead and use underwear right now. I'm just going to apply some bottoms here. We're going to go down to underwear bottoms. We'll apply these darker colored ones, all right? Just double click those. and replace the ones that currently exist there. Right? Because they are the same item, it's just going to replace one for the other. Okay, now once we've done that, we can move on to something like the shirt, for example. Let's go over here to the shirt section. And under shirt, you can just go up here and find something like this noodle strap top. Okay, this is a default embedded content with Character Creator 3. So let's just double click this, and this will automatically apply to our character. Just like that. Now you'll also notice that because that shirt is layered on top of the bra or the bikini top there, the bikini top may poke through. Now there's various ways you can fix this, but what we're going to do is we're just going to delete it. Now if you want, you can go to your scene manager here and you can select it like this. You can select bra, or you can go to noodle strap top, or generally what you can do is you can just double click on a section, okay, just like this, okay, and it'll select it automatically. All right, you can see the bra is selected. And we'll just go ahead and delete that. All right, just delete it like this. And there we go. So now it's a bit cleaner. And let's go back to our content manager here and into the lower pants section. Okay, so pants, basically all the lower body stuff. And we'll go to our default main folder here. You can see we have low-rise shorts. Let's just go ahead and double-click those and apply them to our character. So our character will now have low-rise shorts layered on top of the underwear that we had earlier. Okay, and this one has no mesh breakage, which is great. And after shorts, we can go over here. We don't want to wear a skirt over top of our shorts. So let's go over to coats. Okay, and coats, we have this punk leather jacket. I'm just going to go ahead and double click this and apply it. All right, so now our character is looking a lot more hardcore and punky. All right, and finally, also in the clothing section, we have full body stuff, which we're not going to apply to our character. We're just going to go right over to shoes here, okay, and just select a regular old pair of boots B. Okay, let's zoom out a little bit and focus on our character's feet and just apply those boots B. Now, aside from clothing, we also have accessories over here. So if we click on the accessory section, we have a bunch of accessories, some for the head, some for the torso, like ties and those, like wristwatches on the arms or armor or whatever, some for the legs, and others, other miscellaneous ones. I'm just going to go ahead to this head section here and apply this beret to our character. So let's take a look at our character's head here and just double click the beret. That's going to apply directly to our character's head. And you can see that the hair is poking out a little bit. Now to fix this, since we have an item selected, what we can do is we can use the W hotkey. Okay, the W hotkey will bring up our movement gizmo. You can see it's up here. The E hotkey is the rotation gizmo right here. And the R hotkey is for scale. We'll talk more about these in just a moment. But the W hotkey is very important because we need to kind of bring the hat up a little bit. Okay, and we'll just bring it back a little bit to cover our character's hair like that. And it's still poking through a little bit, so we may need to rotate it. So we'll use the E hotkey to rotate. Okay, just like this. And again, W hotkey, bring it slightly up. And that should cover most of the hair, a little slight bit poking through there. Let's use the E hotkey to rotate even further, just like this. There we go. And then again, you might need to take it back a little bit. W hotkey again, just like that, okay? And we should be good to go. Make sure there's no hair poking through on the back or the front. All right, so now she's all set with her beret. So there's lots of other stuff that you can apply to your character. As you can see here, tons and tons and tons of different options. And we'll talk about that in other tutorials. But for now, let's just take a look. We can press the F hotkey we'll focus on our item that we have selected. If we press the K hotkey, it'll focus on our entire character. Okay, just like this. Now let's take a look at posing the character. We have a number of different poses that are embedded in Character Creator as well. So let's go over here to this section here, which is called Pose. In Pose, we have face and body. We have just body and we have just expressions. All right, let's go to face and body here. And let's choose a female body pose. Okay, so we have something like this enticing one. We can just double click the enticing one. And there, our character will kind of pop into like a sexy kind of enticing pose, just like this. Okay, very cool looking, very suave. Or we can do something like this ponder. Okay, just double click on the ponder and our character will go into a thoughtful pose. Okay, so now this will affect the face and the body. Okay, you can see her face has kind of a weird pondering expression right there. And the body is also posed. Okay, it's because it's motion plus, which is face and body. Okay, now you can do the expression by itself. Let's go into the expression section here. And let's go into female expressions. And we have something like this glancing one we can just apply to our character, okay? So let's apply the glancing one. You can see there she's kind of looking at us. Like, what are you guys looking at? We can move over here. And there you go. So we have our, you know, character in a nice cool-looking pose. You know, she's too cool for school with her punk outfit and the kind of glancing, casual glance look to the side there. Now, very, very, very simple ways to change the lighting in your scene is to go into the IBL section. Okay, that's image-based lighting, IBL. So that's all found in the visual tab here. Okay, so visual tab. If you can't find your visual tab, just go up to window and make sure you have visual settings selected. Okay, you can also use the F7 hotkey. Okay, so in the visual settings at the very first tab here, which is called atmosphere, at the very bottom, you'll find an image-based lighting section here. Okay, so image-based lighting is basically like using this image right here to kind of project light. If we rotate around our scene, you'll see that basically this image is wrapped around our entire scene. Imagine that there's like a circle, a sphere surrounding our character, and this image is wrapped around the inside of it and projecting light from that. That's basically image-based lighting in a nutshell. Now what you can do is you can modify the strength of the image-based lighting to get overall stronger atmospheric light, just like this, okay? You have it very strong or very weak, okay? We can also show our sky. So right now we're showing the image right here. We can choose to hide that, and it'll just be a plain gray background. Or show it again just like this. Now you can also rotate this IBL image in the background as well, but you can go to click this button here. You can also use Shift I, okay? Just click it right here, and it'll bring up a rotation gizmo. Now you'll see that when we rotate this, we'll have shadow coming on the character's face. And then we can, you know, rotate it backwards just like this to the desired location. Okay, so just make sure that you're aware you can rotate your IBL as well and get various looks on your character, various atmospheric effects. So once we're done that, let's take a look at quickly how to render our character. I think we'll just kind of center her here in a very, you know, cool looking pose. If we want to render, there's a couple of easy ways to render. The first way is to go up here and click on render. You can also go up here to the render file item here in preview. You can render an image. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and click render image. Now there's a little panel here that pops up. We can choose a format that we want to render to. In this case, I'm just going to choose JPEG. It's a very small file. We can choose our frame size. I'm going to choose viewport resolution, which is the same resolution as our viewport right here. And I'm just going to go ahead and select a, you know, final render. It doesn't really matter. And you can just go ahead and export it. And just save it to whatever wherever you want, I guess. I'll just save it to my desktop here. We'll just call it test render and go ahead and save that. And then we'll get right here, this right here, okay? Very simple final render. All right, and finally, we can go ahead and save our project. We can go up to File and Save Project As, just like this, and save it to wherever we want. Or an easier way to keep track of your stuff is to go to the Content Manager and go to the Project section up here and click on your Custom tab. All right, and just go ahead and press the plus key. Now we can save this project as whatever we want. Let's call it demo and save it just like that. And you can load that back in whenever you want. Now it's also very easy to just basically directly export your character from Character Creator and replace the character that you have selected in iClone, like in this case. We're in Character Creator now. I'm just going to quickly apply a number of different things to our character. And once we're completed all this magician outfit stuff, again, these are available for purchase from the content store, we can go up to just basically export our character to iClone. You can see here she is with all her cool-looking punk wizard-type outfit stuff here. All right, so just basically go up here. You can go up to File and Export and Export Send Character to iClone. Now, if you have your character in iClone already selected, what's going to happen is it's going to replace that character, in this case the dummy, it's going to replace it with this new character. And once that's replaced, then you can just go ahead and play back the scene, and that character will just take over all the animations of the dummy character. We can see the cool-looking Harry Potter wizard-type stuff right here. All right, so that's really all there is to it, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you learned a lot about the beginnings of Character Creator 3, how to, like, you know, set up a simple project and go from there. And make sure you check out our forums over at forum.reillusion.com, and I hope to see you in the next video.